I think it's safe to say that most software teams today realize that burnout is a very real threat to your software team, but I think that the general view is that burnout is caused by working too much, when in reality, that is just one of the reasons why burnout happens. And one of the other big ones is value conflict. That is what we're going to explore today. I am MPJ, and you are watching Fun Fun Function. A value conflict in the workplace is when you value something highly, but your team doesn't. For example, it might be that you think that unit tests are very important, but your team, they're just not convinced of their value. It might be that you're a person that prefers software that is focused on being bug-free and fast, and instead of having a lot of features, but you find yourself in a team that is basically a feature factory. Or it might be that you're the lone designer on a team, and you have to constantly fight for getting time to do user research. Basically, you believe in something, but the team doesn't. Now, not all value conflicts are destructive. Value conflicts happen all the time because we are humans, we value different things, and it's actually through discussion and these conflicts that we have that great insights happen and we create new and innovative solutions. These value conflicts and you know, pull between people, that's how we create great things, and it's part of the fabric of being human. However, there is a limit to how much you can take. Some of the values that you have, they are extra strong. They are your core values. So you hold a lot of values, but these values, they're closer to your identity as a software developer. For example, one of my core values is to build stuff with care. So for me, just building something that works for the end user, that is great, that is important, but it's not quite enough for me. I also have the need to build something that is maintainable in the long run. And that's a value that some teams have. For example, imagine that you're a product company and you only have one product. In that software team, it's likely that they value maintainability very high. But that is not the reality of all teams. Some teams might be an ad agency, for example, that mostly builds campaign sites. The campaign sites, they are launched once and they have a very high probability of never being changed again. A team like that, they don't value maintainability, and nor should they. But working in such a team would, for me, be very draining. And that is because I would have to constantly suppress something inside of me that is very important to me. I would basically be spending my days in a place where I could not be me, so to speak. In order to function in such a team, I would have to play the role of someone else, and I would have to do that all day, all year long. And it would be even worse if I was in a situation where I would not even think that it was appropriate to suppress that value. For example, let's say that I'm working in this ad agency that puts out campaign sites. Let's say that the agency has been hired to create an application. Like an actual application, not a campaign site, but something that will actually live on for a couple of years. So this new application that we're hired to do, it would definitely benefit from being built in a maintainable way. So I start pushing for that, but the team, they are just not there value-wise. They're used to building campaign sites and they just don't hold my values. So I find myself in a situation where I argue and I argue, but I don't get heard. The people around me, they just don't buy it. And that wears me down. That wears me down so bad. So I think that it is very important that you sit down in your team and discuss what are our values. What do we agree about and what do we disagree about? And here's the most important part, are we okay with those disagreements? Again, some disagreement is perfectly okay, even good, but there's also some values that we just can't afford to disagree on. Some values are just more important to get people in sync on, or people will just start burning out. And that's it. That is what I had on my mind today. You have just watched an episode of Fun Fun Function. I release these every Monday morning 0800 GMT. You can subscribe there if you want to be reminded. But if you don't want to wait until next Monday morning, you can check out this episode that the machine learning Google